สวัสดีครับ Hello everyone Welcome to Zero Corruption I'm Thosathan PM Sambun Each and every year there are millions of foreigners that visit Thailand with different objectives Therefore visas are issued depending on their purpose of visit Some can stay long some can stay short It depends on why they visit Thailand either for fun for work or for entertainment Therefore this creates great confusion when issuing the visa as you can see in the following interview
My name is Martin Porenchio. I'm an instructor in the English department at Thammasat University. I've worked here since 1988, so that'll be 29 years this year. Lately, it's been mostly with the 90-day report. So this is the most common government service that I've used, reporting every 90 days to the local immigration office.
Thailand issues visas for foreigners according to their objective of visiting, which are classified into the following categories. Transit visas are for foreigners who travel through Thailand to reach another country. Tourist visas are for foreigners who travel to Thailand for tourism purposes. Non-immigrant visas are for temporary residents in Thailand who must comply with the conditions as required by law. Diplomatic visas are for diplomats or individuals who serve as consulates. Official visas are for individuals who are conducting government assignments. Courtesy visas are for royal or government guests. Foreigners shall be granted a certain length of authorized stay according to the visa types, such as transit visas grant a maximum of 30 days for authorized stay. Tourist visa provides a maximum period of 60 days. Non-immigrant visas provide a maximum period of 90 days. Should the foreigners seek to lengthen their stay beyond the maximum period, they shall submit a request at the immigration office. The procedure and conditions of each visa type in Thailand are very similar to those of other countries. Foreigners, however, recommend that certain details of these conditions should be revised for greater convenience and practicality.
Well, for myself and many other non-Thais, we wondered about the usefulness of the 90-day reporting. It doesn't seem to accomplish anything. It's just extra work and extra a time-consuming activity for those of us who live here. I'm not sure what purpose it serves. It doesn't necessarily prevent people who are overstaying their visa because they wouldn't do it anyway. The only people reporting are those who follow the law. So I'm not sure what the purpose of such a policy is.
As you can see, foreign investment and tourists are very essential to Thailand. However, visas are very essential as well for national security. But the time-consuming process and the confusion of issuing a visa has led to a proposal of improving the Thailand Data Center. From now on, electronic visa system can be imposed for tourists or for foreign investors traveling into Thailand to work, to visit, or to stay, depending on how long you stay as well. They can submit the form depending on their purpose of visit, which makes it more convenient for foreign investors, foreign visitors, and also foreign tourists as well, making Thailand a greater country for people coming from overseas into Thailand depending on their purpose. And that's all the time we have for today's episode of Zero Corruption. See you next time. สวัสดีครับ